गाइस,
हाय एवरीबॉडी,
हाय सिमरन, हाय अंजलि,
हाय ज्योति,
वेलकम,
हाय ज्योति, हाय तबीरा,
हाय सिमरन, हाय अंजलि,
हाय तबीरा, हाय ज्योति.
So, I think to start off first, we'd like to apologize to all of our viewers. We are a couple of minutes late, but we are here now, and it's going to be a really fun session. So, should we get started?
Yes.
Great. All right. Good afternoon, everybody, and a very warm welcome to the 12th episode of Coffee Conversations with Women on Wealth. As all of you know, we are a women-centric community providing online training and coaching programs to help women not only manage their money, but grow it effectively and become financially empowered. In addition to our training programs, we also run a very popular book club. And also we have a very loved community, which we are all part of. And before I introduce our guests today, I would like to speak a little bit about our theme, which is small steps when taken towards financial freedom, done as a community, can lead to transformation, can be transformational, not only for you, but for your world as well. I'm going to repeat it. Small steps taken towards financial freedom, when done as a community, can be transformational, not only for you, but for your world as well. This line, the more you read, the more impactful it becomes. We, all of us as individuals, have our own vision of a better future. It could be for us, it could be for our loved ones, it could be for the community, or it could be for the larger universe. But none of this is possible unless we decide to take the first step and introspect and define our goals. Once we define our goals and take disciplined steps to achieve them, we will be not only helping ourselves and our near and dear ones, but also making a difference and doing our part to ensure that we have a better future for our children. So here it is, inviting all of us to take the first step, define our goals, follow them, and also invite everybody around you to take their first step. With that, we have these two beautiful women who decided to take the first step and bring understanding and clarity to their financial life. And they are very excited to share this journey with you. Simran Rekhi, who is a director of a boutique travel company and is someone who has found a very interesting way to instill the value of money in her children's lives. So everybody with children, you need to listen up to this one. And Dr. Anjali Dogra, a general physician based in Delhi with not so good an internet connection. So let's hope that we have her with us for the next 30 minutes. And without wasting any more time, I'm going to bring Anjali on first. Anjali, why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself, your background, where you're from, just a few lines for our audience.
So I'm a general physician and I've been practicing in Delhi for now almost since 2012. And I work in a clinic in Mayur Vihar. I'm married. I have two kids, a 15-year-old son and a 5-year-old daughter. And I mean, that's my journey. That's me.
Nice. Thank you. And Simran, what about you? Why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Yeah. Firstly, guys, I really like to thank you for inviting me on this platform and giving me this opportunity to share my experiences with the women out there. I'm a Delhi girl, born and brought up in Delhi. Typically in a Punjabi house, where the entire family stays together, all uncles, aunts, grandparents, kids, cousins, everybody together. My family consists of my parents and we are three sisters. I'm the middle one. And from my family, I belong to a family of journalists, and the name of our publication is the Sheri Punjab publication. It's a Urdu newspaper which was started by my great grandfather in 1911, and this title was given to us by the government of India owing to the participation of my grandfather's great grandfather's fight in the fight for freedom. And since then, my father, my uncle, they are continuing with this legacy that's been bestowed upon us. I grew up in Delhi, and I did my schooling from Guru Har Krishna Public School, and I did my post graduation from Jesus and Mary School. From where on, I did my post graduation in business management from Core School. Right after my management program, I was lucky enough to have a campus placement at Bharti Telecommunications, where I worked for 3 years. I then met my husband in 2006, and we got married. And he's a wonderful person. He's also been with the corporate world for the last 20 years. At the same time, he's been also very helpful to my father-in-law in managing the family real estate business. I'm blessed with two amazing kids. My daughter Seher is 9 years, and my son Anhad is 4 years. On a professional front, after I got married, I started my own boutique travel company by the name U Tours in 2010. It was, solely born out of my passion for and love for travel and, experiencing new cultures and visiting new destinations, which is why I created this profession for myself. And we specialize into customizing travel packages, both domestic and international. Our aim is not just to sell, packages and tickets. Our aim is to sell an experience, which is why I've been associated with this profession, because I thoroughly love and enjoy it. It's been 10 years now since I started, and I only feel it's just the tip of the iceberg, and there's still yet more to learn and more to explore.
Amazing.
Thank you, Simran. Thank you, Anjali, for your introduction. So tell me, Simran, what brought you to Women on Wealth? How did Women on Wealth happen?
So basically, as a commerce background student, I have always had this inclination and interest towards, stocks and investments since childhood. And, back in the days when I used to work at Airtel, I had a stint at, trying to trade online with the help of my colleagues, and they would keep guiding me, either invest kade, either dikadalo, then nikaldo, and all that stuff. But it was very, very chaotic, and I would be always, a bundle of nerves, and oh, the stock fell down, or okay, very happy the stock, I earned some profit in it. So it was a roller coaster ride, something that I couldn't understand, but it was all a bundle of excitement for me. So I left it at that, and I was quite intrigued by it, and I was like, hey, sometime in future, definitely, I'm going to give it a try. And thanks to you, Jyoti, I remember the time when we met at that birthday party and where you introduced me to this program, and I was all excited and all lit up that, yes, now is the time that I can actually, try to learn more about the stocks program. And that's when I jumped in. And since then, there's been no looking back. I, religiously have been trying to invest a certain part of my income, my salary or whatever I earn into stocks, and very diligently invest into it. And now, since I have enough time in my hand right now, I'm able to follow my passion. Secondly, when I got married, I used to see and observe my father-in-law. He's very fond of investing in stocks and mutual funds. And the way he used to handle his portfolio, he used to take his daily dose of information from newspaper and refer to, magazines like Value Research. So like every family, the elders, pass on the baton to the juniors, to the young generation. So our father was very keen on us to take over these responsibilities. And my husband and I actually thought of it as a challenge that we should, get more equipped with the knowledge, the right knowledge to handle his portfolio. We took this as a challenge on ourselves. But having said that, my husband working in the corporate had a very busy travel schedule, and he was barely able to give some time and effort to this. So then I stepped in and I was like, let me start with this program. Let me first take in the knowledge, and then maybe I can carve a path and direction for both of us to join in together and take this responsibility. It's a huge responsibility, somebody's life saving and their earnings throughout the life to manage it and then to do justice to it. So this was the whole agenda behind this entire program for me, and it kind of really worked very well for me from there on.
Well, I am really glad that my conversation with you made you start. So, good.
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks to you.
What about you, Anjali? What challenges brought you to Women on Wealth?
Well, I think for me, it was you know, in 2012, I started my own clinic, and it was like a big thing for me. Since there are no doctors in our family, I was one alone starting this whole thing on my own. And it was like a big, you know, it was like great to be an entrepreneur. But somewhere down the line, 6 years, I realized that, you know, something is missing. I'm not making that, you know, that sort of, you know, that the financial, you know, gap was there. I wasn't making as much income as I should be making. I guess was enjoying my practice a lot, but the business of the, you know, the practice was not making sense to me. And somewhere, you know, I felt maybe this is not my cup of tea, and I wound up my business and I started looking for a job. At that time, I was pretty underconfident. You know, I honestly I was going through this really tough phase wherein I had started something so, you know, it on a big scale, and suddenly had to wind it up. At that time, I kind of started thinking, maybe there's something which I'm missing out. You know, I need to really go back and get my, you know, financial, you know, know-how, get things, you know, have more knowledge in this field. And I met a friend of mine who kind of introduced me to Women on Wealth. And that's probably a turning point for me, because I realized that there's so much is actually missing, you know, for me. And how in so many other ways I could have actually improved my business and my clinic. And now when I, you know, like it's been 2 years since I've been associated, I feel I'm going to go back and start all over again, maybe again start my clinic. So for me, this is like now, you know, wherein I think this was a big turning point, and yes, a new start also.
Wow, that's so nice to hear, Anjali, and you know, the difference it's made. You know, it kind of leads me to my next point. And I think before I ask the question, I just want to share something. You know, we had our community meet recently, and the Money Gym community meet. And in that, the theme of it was a lot around pay it forward. And as you know, this is our one of our core values of the community. And I think that is what has driven us to do these coffee conversations as well. So while we look to define our own goals and achieve them, it's so important for us to be together as a community, because unless we move together, we are never going to get somewhere. We are bound to get dropped. And, you know, that's where it brings in that both of you have been brought in by friends who've seen a need. And, you know, it's so nice to hear how people are able to communicate the need, and from your part to acknowledge it and then want it, to take the first step. And then from the friends who've referred you to be, you know, that, okay, they need, we can help them. And then to see that all of you have benefited from it. So that's, I think that's amazing. And that kind of takes me on to my next point, which is that we'd like to know a little bit more about how the programs have helped you, Anjali, and how are you kind of utilizing the methodologies that you did learn?
I think the program made me realize it wasn't that my income was less. It was actually that I wasn't doing something right with the money I had in hand. And it was an eye-opener, you know, when we go through the Money Gym program, we look at our shopping habits. And I always thought I wasn't much of a shopper, you know. I always just think I'm a very, you know, balanced person. But when I looked at my habits, I realized, you know, that actually there are certain things which are leading to a lot of excess buying. So those small things, you know, like we do the money in, money out program, just keeping a track of your daily expenses can make a huge difference. So these small things made me realize that it's actually, you know, we look at, say, that income is less. Probably income is adequate. It's just that we're not handling it in the right way. You know, right. Our approach, the attitude we have towards money. I really want to thank the Money Gym program, because it's built that attitude. Today, I'm more cautious about myself. I really check myself. Do I need it? Can I do without it? Is it really a need or a want? We have this, you know, we go through this where we are asked, do you need it or do you want it? So, you know, it's actually so simple. And that's what I enjoyed about the program, that it made it so simple.
Yeah, true. And it's so simple to then keep following it.
Yeah, I mean, and you know, that's the best part, that the community is there to, you know, be with you. Yes, you'll always have that challenge that you may not be able to keep up. It will always be that, you know, you might not be keeping up your expenses, but the community is there to support you, to guide you. So I think that's what it is, that that's the start of your program, and the community is there to guide you through. So I think it's like, you know, this 360 degree thing, which is there with you. So it changes your life, and yes, it makes sure the changes with you.
I agree with that. And I think when you do the structures daily, when you start applying them daily and monthly, it kind of becomes who you are. So it becomes a way of life. And then this also happens, that the other people are not able to relate with you. Like my mom, she calls me this big conjuice who refuses to spend money. And I'm like, yeah, you know, but I don't really need it, so why should I buy it? So that's a conversation I often have with my mother. But it kind of becomes who you are. And it's a nice feeling. I completely agree and resonate with you, Anjali.
Nice. And Simran, what about you? You're on mute. Yeah, now we can hear you.
So like I said, that we took this, me and my husband, as a challenge to, you know, empower ourselves with the right knowledge to take on this mammoth task. And thankfully, the program worked wonders for us. You know, I started getting involved in our, you know, this meetings of mutual funds where my father-in-law would make me sit and, you know, value the advice that I would give. And, you know, me and my husband started working as a team where we'd be in sync of all our investments and all the financial decisions that we had to make, whether it's related to our family, to our kids, for our kids. And that was a great feeling, actually. That was very exciting. And the beauty about this program is, you know, the various structures and sheets that were shared with us during the entire tenure of the program, like, you know, setting up of your visions and goals, and something that I have been doing my entire life, but you need a roadmap to, you know, reach those places and reach your goals. So, you know, setting up the right expectations from yourself and setting up the right roadmap to where you want to reach, to something like calculating your net worth sheet to know where exactly you stand in present. And from here, how you want to, you know, build in small habits like this money in and money out sheet, or, you know, the discarding of the things that you don't require. I think all of us have done that program, and it actually gave a sense that, you know, so much money we end up wasting on our impulses and impulse shopping. Something that we don't even need, and we don't even use them for a long time, and such a waste of money. That has definitely brought in a sense of, you know, respect that, you know, no, it's something to be saved, something to be wisely used and spent, rather than, you know, you just, you know, impulse buys, and, you know, wasting, and it doesn't serve any purpose. So definitely the entire structure of the program has helped. The exciting part is that finally I've got into stocks and I've started investing in my stocks, and it's a, you know, bit of an excitement. And the major learning for this program had been with something that I've realized now during the COVID times, because something that we've always been anticipating, what if the market hits low and then all your stocks go on a loss? So this is something that we've been taught and trained that, you know, if the market goes low, you don't get anxious. You wait and you watch, then you use your knowledge that you've been taught, and then you decide what you should do. So that's been amazing. And I was also very anxious, whether should I sell my stock? I've invested a lot of money in stocks and the market's all-time low. But we waited, and a lot of us also took it as an opportunity to invest further in the market rather than, you know, losing it and, you know, withdrawing all our money. And now when the market has picked up while we waited, I've seen a lot of my stocks surfacing quite strongly. So I'm really, really excited. And I've seen this low, and I just can't wait to see the highs.
You know, that's so nice. Actually, today itself, someone in the community wrote on the WhatsApp group, said that they finally, you know, have seen their portfolio going into green. And what a nice feeling.
Yeah, so it was all red. Believe you me, it was all red. And I was like, should I really, you know, log out? But no, I'm glad that we, Priyanka kept telling us to, you know, wait and watch. And I'm so glad we waited. And it's quite green now. I was happy to see the green signs.
Nice.
And I feel that is the beauty of having a community, because when the market crashes, many people tend to get anxious, which is a natural thing.
Absolutely.
But then you have this community with you telling you that it's okay. You know, I love the way, I don't know whether you were there or not, Simran, but in March when this whole market crashed and the market was bleeding and everything was happening, Priyanka had done a session, like, you know, just out of the blue, a session for everyone that come on and let's discuss what's happening. And I feel that when you're on your own and you are dealing in, you know, stocks and mutual funds, when you're on your own, you don't know who to really consult. But when you're in a community, you can always fall back to your members. You can always fall back to the people over there to help you get out of, you know, to get out of this whole thing. So, yeah.
I totally agree with you, Jyoti, because without the help of community and people telling you what's the right thing to do, I think if I was on my own, the way I was back in my corporate years, I definitely would have, you know, probably logged out at a loss, and then I would have been cursing myself that market's up now and I should have just, you know, held back. So you're absolutely right. The community plays a very important role there.
Yeah. So tell me, Simran, I'll come to you first. So the knowledge that you have gathered in Women on Wealth, have you applied that with your kids?
Yes, Jyoti, that's a very important part. I have. And you know why I did that? Because, you know, growing up, we had a very humble beginning. My father worked really, really hard and struggled to give us the best in our lives. And I very closely seen my father while he used to go for work, and I've accompanied him many times. And it used to be unbelievable. So much so that, you know, next day I'm like, Papa, I don't want to go with you anymore. I can't handle all this hard work and stress and pressure that you do every day. But at the same time, it made me respect money a lot. It made me very grounded that, you know, whatever you are living and whatever you're having, it is because your parents work very hard for it. So you should not take it for granted. Something that I really want to, you know, bring into my kids. The day and age we are in right now, it's very easy that the kids can get spoiled and pampered. And they always come up to you, Mama, we want this from Amazon. And can you buy this for us and this and that? And as parents, you know, you feel that it's okay. One thing, you know, you end up buying them and you always fulfilling their wishes. But they don't learn anything out of that. You know, you end up spoiling them. So having said that, I thought it's about time that I should, at least with my daughter who's 9 years old, I should at least start introducing small habits of, you know, spending wisely and saving nicely. So I decided very recently, in fact, we decided that, you know, we are going to set a list of tasks for you for the week, whether be it, you know, waking up on time, doing your bed, you know, you're studying on time, finishing your homework, whatever the list be. And we will review it every Sunday. And once you've done your completed the entire task, we will pay you your pocket money. And somehow she got very excited with the idea that, you know, she'll be getting something out of it. So we put this in this habit. And now Jyoti, seriously, she takes it so seriously. She's been doing it. She's been following it up. She eyes something on Amazon. She's like, Mama, oh, it's 200 rupees or 300 rupees. I have to work for 2-3 certain weeks to, you know, get that much money. And then I can buy it. I say, yes, make your way through it. And that's what she's been doing. And recently she ordered something on Amazon with her own money. And when it came, she was super excited. And she was like, you know, so it's an amazing thing to bring these habits and tasks early on in the kids. And so the four important things that I think the kids learn out of this, A, they complete their task on time. And they have a sense of ownership and responsibility and achievement and pride that they've done it through the week. B, they work hard for 2-3 weeks together and, you know, get that money. So it gives them a sense of realization that it's not easy. They've worked hard to achieve what they've achieved. And also I ask her to maintain a small money in, money out notebook where she's keeping a track. Mama gave me this much and I spend this much and this is what I'm left with. So, you know, introducing a little bit of accounting at this stage where she can maintain her accounts right now so that, you know, she doesn't have to deal with the problem that we are dealing with now. And also, you know, simple things like this can help her track her money, bring her the realization that, you know, it's not easy and we should respect money and, you know, save as and when, use as and when required. And I think seeing this, my younger one is also quite keen to follow her footsteps. And he's already excited. Whenever she gets her money, he also gets excited. And he says, Mama, I also want money. And like, first you go and learn your accounting and then we'll talk about this. Yeah, so it's important in this day and age too.
So
yeah, it's important, you know, because they can easily get pampered and it's really important to keep them grounded and have respect for money.
No, I agree with you. I also have my 7-year-olds. I better start some practices with them. But yeah, it's amazing. I love the way you shared that.
Thank you
so much. What about you, Anjali? How have you applied this knowledge with your kids? Anjali, you're on mute.
Yeah. So with my son, you know, like he gets a certain amount of money from his grandparents. So this time I told him, I said, you know what, why don't you invest it in stocks? And he's like, that sounds good. I should do that. So then we sat down and had a discussion. And I said, you know, so which company? He says, like, I don't know. What, you know, like which company? So then I, you know, gave him a couple of names. And I said, why don't you study the companies and tell me which one you'd like to invest in? So then he did a bit of study. And then he told me, and he said, I've come across these terms like pledging of stocks. So then we had a discussion on, you know, so what is all that? And then, so it was very interesting. You know, we were having these conversations about stock market, and it was like, he was like, this is a whole new world, you know, and it's so complicated. And then finally he has shortlisted a company, and he's told me that, okay, you please buy stocks for me, and this is my money. So, and I said, we'll keep a track of it. He said, yeah, sure. So it was nice to, you know, have that conversation with him. He's 15 years old, and he's kind of, you know, taking a first step into the world of stocks. So nice.
You know, it's so inspiring to hear both your stories about how you're instilling it in the house. And I think I missed pointing it out, Simran, but earlier, you know, you said, when you spoke about what helped you, you said it's, you know, we. So it was very nice to hear that both you and your husband both are in it. Because, you know, I guess when you all, and it goes for both of you, when you come in together as a family, the impact is much more than what a single person can do. And I think that's another thing that's a big common point that has come out in all of these conversations. And I believe last week, Ridhima had mentioned it as well, that where, you know, she started and her husband decided to, you know, also jump in and, take the course and start following the structure. So the impact, of course, is much bigger. And now hearing it that both your kids are involved, I think then that just takes it to the next level. So, you know, with that, we are going to come to our last question now. And it's an important question for us to ask, because we like people to, you know, take one big takeaway with them. So, Anjali, I'm going to ask you first, what is that big takeaway, you know, sort of a big advice that you'd want to put out to our audience and to any women watching us today?
Can you just repeat the question? Sorry, I didn't get you.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Okay, so I was talking about, like, you know, what is that big, one big message or a takeaway you'd like to share with the audience, you know, all the people watching, all your friends and family? I think Anjali's similar. Maybe
one
can
thing it okay, that comes to my mind is that. So the one thing that comes to my mind is that, you know, alone I would never have been able to do this. It's only that, you know, you need a mentor, and having a mentor in Women on Wealth, having Priyanka there to guide you, and the community support. Alone, it's just not possible. And every day, you know, it's such a, like, one step further towards your goal, one step further into, you know, getting clarity on financial matters. I think even on a larger scale, you know, alone, you just can't do it. So I think the support of the community is so vital. And it brings a very important, you know, point that we need each other. We need to be there for each other. And Women on Wealth brings that so beautifully forward.
Yeah, true. So nicely put. So the power of the community. Simran, what about you?
Dabira, I think a lot of women, you know, sometimes underestimate the fact that, you know, that underestimate themselves, and they always think that, you know, finance and investments are something that can only be handled by men, and there's nothing that, you know, we can play a part in, or, you know, put our thoughts in. But they often tend to forget that they are the finance ministers of their own household. And, you know, the expenses, the way they manage the expenses to keep the house running smoothly, keep everybody happy, and at the same time, end up saving some for the rainy days as well. So they underestimate themselves a lot. And I would just say that, you know, get out of this bubble of self-doubt, and, you know, take charge of your investments, and take charge of your future financial planning. And involve your partner in it, and you never know, together as a team, what wonders you can do, and how you can secure your family for future. You know, the key takeaway here is that your fears and your self-doubt would disappear once you have the right knowledge. So the most imperative part for me to join this program was to gain the right knowledge and to empower myself that, you know, yes, I can do this, and I can, you know, make investments for myself and for my family, for my kids as well. Like I mentioned earlier, the structures that were shared to us, you know, they were both in sync with my vision and my goal for future. And without this right skill set or knowledge, I would probably have been going in a vicious circle and, you know, ending up with the same result and then still wondering why don't I end up, you know, with the same, with any savings, or why don't I end up being having enough money at hand. So definitely it's taught me a lot. I'm a dreamer since childhood, and always like in believe in dreaming big. But thanks to Women on Wealth, I now have devised a roadmap to, you know, working towards my vision. That's why I feel that it's very important to have the right knowledge, as it gives you a sense of direction, it empowers you, and gives you the confidence to make more informed and conscious decisions, financial decisions, for yourself and for your family. And once you have the right knowledge, you can ask the right questions. So how I implied this whole thing to myself was, I always ask these questions, 4 W's, in my work as well. The 4 W's for me are who, where, what, and when. So who is, the way I applied it in this program was who to invest, which companies to invest in, what funds I'm looking at, where to invest in, whether it's mutual funds or stocks or bonds or PPF schemes, what is my portfolio like, and what my portfolio should be certain years down the line. And what should it comprise of? Certain percent of debt, certain percent of equity, certain percent gold. And finally, when is the right time to jump in the market? When is the right time to stay put or withdraw? And when is the right time that my goods would be materialized? So when I applied all these questions to this program, it was a completely different experience out of it. I was able to ask the right questions. I was able to apply this knowledge towards in making informed decisions and informed investments. And so now, after 1 year, I joined this program in July last year. And when I look back into this 1 year long journey, I really evolved as a person in terms of my knowledge for the market and for related to my finance and investments. And there's one person I really want to truly thank, and that's Priyanka, who's been my role model and who's always pushed us to think out of the box, not to take what is given to us, to keep checking, and keep asking questions, and, you know, think of possibilities that there can be, and always guiding us and helping us through various processes. Having said that, I'm also very blessed to be a part of this community of such strong and wonderful, warm women who are always willing to support you, who are always willing to help you. And I know myself, I've stopped so many times in track, and there's always somebody jumping in and, you know, helping me get back on track. A few women like I had a pleasure to meet and learn from, like last year, Aditi, Ankita, Meenal, and girls like yourself. So I'm really, really proud and really thankful to be a part of this community, because it keeps your mindset very positive and, keeps you going no matter what. So I think overall, it's been a very win-win situation for me in every aspect. Yeah, I got the knowledge to make my financial dreams come true and to make more conscious decisions regarding my future investments. B, that I got to learn so many structures and plans to, you know, put in place and to be able to reach where I'm able to reach with these goals. And C, that I'm going to be working this together with a company of amazing and wonderful women who are always have my back, and I know they'll always be there to support me whenever I need them. And lastly, I just so wish that more and more women could join in and be a part of this life-changing experience.
Thank you. Thank you, Simran, for sharing your thoughts. And thank you, Anjali. We completely agree in the value that you guys have just spelled out here for us.
Thank you. Thank you, Simran, thank you, and Anjali, for sharing your stories with us. Very, very inspiring. Before we end this session, I want to share something with everyone who's listening to us today. So for the longest of time, I have had the belief that one should do things on their own. I have often heard this say to my own daughters, why don't you do this craft activity on your own? You're smart, you can handle it, you can do it on your own, you don't need Didi's help. Or many times I have heard parents boast about their kids and say, oh, you know, my daughter made this craft by herself, or my son made this school project himself, even though the child might have taken the help of an adult, but yet we don't like to announce that. Why? Because as parents, we feel that if we announce to the world that our child took help, then he or she might not be considered smart enough or creative enough. Do you see over here, the focus is not on the appreciation that the child has made this activity, but on the fact that whether the child did it himself or not. But if we look at the situation in a different manner, one of our community leaders, Kushali Shah, shared this perspective and I quite loved it. She said, how about if we allow and encourage our kids to learn to co-create and collaborate? What if we reward our kids for collaborating, doing craft activities together, making a school project together in a team? Why are we telling them that if they take help, they are weak? On the contrary, it can become much more fulfilling when we do things together. We save time, we save energy, we make many more friends as we work with each other. So let's call this concept smart work. I loved it. I loved her perspective on this. You must be wondering, why am I sharing this with you? Today, I invite all of you to apply the same concept in your life as adults. If there is anything I have learned since being a part of Women on Wealth, it is the importance of doing things together. There is always someone in this community to push you, to motivate you, to guide you when you get lost, or if you're feeling confused, there is always someone to get you back on track. There is always someone to lift your confidence and tell you, you know what, you can do this. In a community, there is so much more you can learn than when you do it alone. I want to end today's session by quoting an author called Helen Keller. She says, alone we can do so little, but together we can do so much more. So thank you so much for giving us your time. We will see you next Monday, 13th July at 5 p.m. with two new community members sharing their new stories. Till then, take care and do remember to take action with your financial life. Thank you, Simran. Thank you, Anjali, for an awesome session.
Thank you, guys. Thank you. It was a pleasure.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you.
Thank you, Tabira. You were awesome. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Have you all?
We can leave.